Previously on Trails in the Reverie, Tho reunited with her classmates and pondered her career choices. In Crossbell, Machias and Dudley had to foil a pair of familiar con artists in order to restore the supply chain for Vingsep's coffee. Alright, now I get to play as Cedric.
I perfectly understood the choice I made. For the first time in my life, I made a choice entirely of my own free will. There's no one to cling to anymore, no one to protect me. Such is the path I choose to walk.
Crimson Arc Glorious.
Who in their right mind would call this clean?
Maid!
That's right. What am I doing?
Yeah, they're only maid left for some reason. Left for the Reinford family.
I need some fresh air.
Fallen Prince. But still, do they really have maids on in the main campus? I thought the main campus was more unified, but I guess people can still bring their maids and butlers along if they need it, huh? Yeah, I thought the main campus was supposed to erase the distinction between the nobles and commoner classes. My first months as part of society were grueling and painful. I began as an enforcer candidate and struggled through one ordeal after the next under Shirley's watchful eye. From some of these came a stark realization. I was naive, feeble, and a sorry excuse for a human being.
You're the saddest bunch I ever met, but you can bet before we're through, Mr. I'll make a man out of you.
This is how the Red Constellation trains, by jogging a lot? Less choking, more moving. If this was an actual battlefield, your lollygagging would have killed you. Your royal blood means nothing here. You think I don't know that?
You're a spineless, pale, pathetic lot, and you haven't got a clue. Somehow I'll make a man out of you.
Ugh. Yeah, do not try to match do not try to win a contest of strength against someone with a giant chainsaw. Ugh. Ugh. Damn it, Kurt was right about the evading meta! Why didn't I listen to him? That was what caused him to leave me in the first place, actually! I need to be weaker without the Imperial Fortress's power, but this is pathetic! You trying to board me instead of beat me to death, kiddo? Another round, please! I think that's enough for one day. She leaves me in the dust like it's nothing. They sure aren't going easy on him just because he used to be a prince, huh? In Ouroboros, only the strong succeed. There's no place for the pampered. Even though I struggle to find my feet at first. Well, if he fails to become an enforcer, I can always use a Narlaki. You'll be the next Gilbert if you don't succeed, huh? Damn it all. Sorry. I thought I could do better than that. Did I even learn anything at Fours? No, what am I thinking? I knew this wouldn't be easy. I didn't choose this expecting anything to be handed to me. So why did I feel so... Just like I thought, he's still too soft. Take the word in a little darkness buried in your heart to become an enforcer. Where he sinks or swims is entirely up to him at this point. Which reminds me, I heard you went to Shirley with a request, Professor. Since when did you two get so cozy? Yes, I approached her about creating the ideal conditions for an experiment of mine. I realize her men have their hands plenty full, but I'm still hopeful they can provide me with some useful data. Days later surely led me to the ancient battlefield in Crossbell for reasons I wasn't made privy to. What awaited me was a training exercise harsher than anything they had given me before. You want me to take on the Red Constellation and a group of enhanced Jaegers alone? Sure do, all you gotta do is survive to the end and give Gareth and Gilbert a good fight. They both use red as their color scheme, both the enhanced Jaegers and the Red Constellation. That is kind of confusing. I think they should have a battle between them to determine who should change their colors, but I'm pretty sure the Red Constellation is going to win. It's not like you'll really be all alone. You'll have your little partner I borrowed from the professor to help you out. He said something about wanting to test combat links between people and their chaisms or something. This is your new best friend. I'm sure you'll figure it out. Maybe use it as a diversion or something. Get creative. Oh, and we set up some gizmos that will insulate the battlefield sound, so feel free to go ape. You can't think this oversized toy is going to be of any use to me. Sad robot noises. What's the point of giving me a task that I have no chance of succeeding at? Look, you're scared of giving this a shot. You're free to run away like a little baby. I invite you, but no one is forcing you to say. Want to run? There's the door. No one here will be coming after you. But ask yourself if you wouldn't live to regret it. That's a decision you gotta make for yourself. Not as a prince, but as your own person. Oh, and this front gate's locked. It'd be too easy if it wasn't, so find some other way inside, got it? And also... What the? There's your cue. Off you go. I wouldn't stand in one spot for too long if I were you. Because I told Gareth he's welcome to put you down if he has a clean shot. You must be kidding. Fine, I'm going. He's here. Our orders were not to hold back. Let's get him. Damn it. Well, there I... Why? They have a casting turn, and I don't. Great. But he has... Huh. Oh, he started with a bunch of buffs. But Burning Cry will let me extend it. But it's also going to delay me quite a bit. Damn it.
Flames that kindle within me.
Ignite!
Well, good thing that guy didn't take advantage of a zero arts bonus. No, my robot buddy! How dare you!
Grant me strength! Carmine Heart!
That's right, there's no damage prediction mechanic like in Dystopia, so I won't be able to know if my choices are any good. Arts Canceler. Too bad no one here used any arts. Please, crit. No!
What? Very well.
Area M. I don't think that's big enough for all of these guys. Oh crap, I lost my strength buff because of that guy, so I better use Talisman Blades. It's the only one that'll actually work here.
Got you! Talisman Blade!
I can't crit with at all. What? Missed.
Very well.
I have some spells, but I don't know if they'll be good enough. These guys are weak to water, but not to wind. Shoot. Oh crap, he's casting faster than me! My robot's almost dead? Curing?
Huh? Here I go!
No, my robot's almost dead and I have nothing I can heal with because he's all my MP. Why is this robot so weak? Okay, seriously, these guys are pretty damn tanky. Mostly this robot's as good as dead. I think I'm just gonna go for Talisman Blade.
Got you! Talisman?
I'm gonna steal that crit bonus though.
Flames, flicker, and roar! Now, gather in my blade! Purgatory! My little.
Recurio and self, huh? Yeah, I'm just gonna go hang back here. You do your thing, Prince C-Boy.
Here I go!
So he has impede by default, huh? Might as well cast Earth Pulse on you as well. Keep you alive.
Here I go! Flip!
Honestly, this thing is probably just best for just spamming the shit out of support spells and calling it good.
Very well.
You're mine!
Why would you... Very well. My range should only be like one or two with his sword, right? Yeah. Give or take. Dang, why do you only have fire spells? This thing needs a better... this machine needs a better setup. I guess just cast Adamantine Shield on yourself in case that guy goes after you.
Very well. Very well. Flee.
Yeah, he can just maintain his CP really easily, so that's a plus, but other than that...
Here I go!
You're on fire? Okay. Just nuke you with a Purgatory Saber?
Why you?
Yeah, take advantage of healing spells. Melt Gunner, that's what you're calling it? Beowulf and Erda. The Melt Gunner has no Master Quartz, so... Pan, how can even ranking file Jaegers be this strong? I don't know, you beat them all by yourself. They can't be that strong, right? Well, by yourself and with a robot, but still. Ugh. His reflexes aren't too shabby. No wonder the commander sees potential in him. You call this a fair fight? How do you expect anyone to win when they're outnumbered by? Hey, do you know who you're shooting at? Don't think you're gonna get away with this. I don't know, who are we shooting at? And what are you going to do about it? Always use a target to hunt down, so that's what we're going to do. Keep your head on a swivel if you don't want to lose it. Surrounded. Ha! Arg! Are these guys seriously having trouble with a freaking robot? Damn. But still, there's too many of them. Even if we try to take shortcuts by jumping up the ledge, there's just another one waiting for us. This isn't like any training I've been subjected to in my whole life. Is she really trying to have me killed? Was the main campus just super easy or something? What's the point of me having me hunted like a wild animal? Didn't you guys go to North Ambria and clean up the remaining archaisms or something? I guess the archaisms would be weaker than the Jaegers. I don't know. And how is your robot buddy still alive? Like, even if you can heal it, it still seems kind of ridiculous for the robot to last this long against the Jaegers. Must be a really good robot. This is absurd. I'm Cedric Race Arnor. I shouldn't be subjected to a fight for my life like this. That little thing is already seems to be way more durable than some of the bigger archaisms. Or at least, maybe it's because it's just spamming its healing spells. Just mainly designed to keep you alive and not much else. Why is this happening to me? What did I ever do to deserve? Listen to me act like I'm still a prince of the Imperial family and not some nobody. People have been sent to Gehenna for far less than the unspeakable crimes they've committed over the last year. And don't even try to say that you were just being manipulated, Cedric. You did it because you wanted to. It was your own will, your own desires, that led you to go astray, help start a war, and finally end up in this society. I need to grow the hell up and start taking responsibility for my own life.
That's right. All I am now is Cedric, an unjustly proud, no-good fool. I turned my back on my friends, family, and country the moment I chose this path. That's what they've been trying to get through my thick skull this entire time. So I refuse to die like a worthless dog out here. I won't let that happen. It would be an insult to them after all they've done for me.
Surrendering?
I do believe that's my line. Because if you don't, then I'm going to cut you down where you stand. Now, come at me!
About time.
So you managed to make it here after all. To be honest, I didn't think you'd still be in one piece.
I wouldn't be if I tried to fight them all at once. I'm wise enough to know how to scatter the enemy and slip by them. It's a basic military tactic that I learned at the academy. Now all that's left is defeating you two, and I'll have passed. Don't expect me to take it easy on you.
Is it me, or is there something different about you?
You finally found the resolve to face your fate head on. Good. Then I will respond in kind. You shall be tested by the Blitz as the Young Miss Order.
Have it your way. Test me as you see fit.
I still don't get the whole flippin' attitude, but fine. You're about to learn that the world is a cold, cruel place. I, Gilbert Stein! Regimental Commander of the 6th Enhanced Jaeger Brigade shall be your tutor!
We'll see if you can get past us.
Just don't get cocky! You're still new around here!
What is with you? I didn't notice, this guy, even though he seems like he should be balanced between physical and magic, he has high hit points but not a whole lot of EP. I thought he'd at least equip some burn EP managing stuff on him. Dang it. Well, Burning Cry. Just to get my buffs up.
Flames that kindle within me.
Ignite!
Why are you using your healing items now, dude? I didn't even attack you yet. Oh, it's a buff to strength. No, my robot!
Come on!
Very well.
Why is your Brave Order so expensive? It's only a 25% boost. I'm pretty sure that's the same as Reen's. Like, all you get is like a bunch of CP, but your self-buff already restores a ton of CP anyways. Ugh. Anyways. Where are you all weak to? Time. Earth. I don't... Damn it. Ow. This will hopefully be more economical than using that space art from earlier. I only set one of you guys on fire? Seriously? Lame. Please don't move, Gilbert. Also, I need a weapon break so that you don't deal so that hopefully I can take out some of that strength of yours. Yes, Link! Finally! A Link attack. A proper one. No, he's got a zero craft! Oh, he missed. Somehow. I'll take it. Maybe Cedric was smart enough to put on an Esmolus gem. Damn, you guys really won't die.
Very well.
Grant me strength! Carmine Heart!
Here I go!
I don't have any more fire damage in me. Shit. I'm gonna have to just start using regular attacks. What? He dodged me! Why didn't you put in more hit courts? Yes! Okay, I need to Earth Pulse you though, you are dying.
Very well!
You don't have an impede, do you? Oh no, poison! That dealt a lot of damage. Actually, holy shit.
Got you! Talisman!
Alright! Man, these guys... Ugh. I take away their strength, but it's not working. Support? You can throw items? Seriously? Dude, that's Gilbert's thing.
Come on!
Here I go!
If I can just isolate Gilbert, that would be great.
Talisman? Blade!
Yes. Seriously? Okay. Armor break.
Very well.
Can this guy use arts from far away? I hope not. I really want to set him on fire too. AT delayed.
You're finished.
No. Yes, he actually did get set on fire, and that actually took out quite a bit of hit points. But I need to start recasting some buffs.
Curses! So you know how to scrap after all.
Very well.
Flames that kindle within me.
Ignite!
This is what I'm really capable of!
Very well.
Damn, he's... I don't think any of my ailments are gonna work on him anymore.
Very well.
I'm just gonna have to wait for a damn thing to run out. He's gonna use his S-craft at some point.
Hold on a second! I'm so sorry! See? Look at me! Please! Can't we all just get along? Oh dear. This is what you get! You gotta be...
I need still a crit bonus.
Flames, flicker, and roar! Now, gather in my blade! Purgatory Saber!
Fence break.
Grant me strength! Carmine Heart!
What?
Very well.
Here I go!
Heal you up.
I've got you.
No, my buddy!
Here I go!
Please set you on fire. Please, that'd be great.
Very well.
Try again. If I can set him on fire, he basically dies. Basic bomb. He's running out of the good stuff. That did nothing. This guy's useless as an attack caster. Better off just using, like, weapon break or something. Missed.
Very well.
I'm just gonna finish you off with Purgatory Saber. You're pretty much near death anyways.
This wasn't supposed to happen.
Blorf.
This is just the beginning.
Also, level 126. But depending on when this took place, doesn't this mean he's way higher level than Class 7 is at the same... And also, he actually has Link experience with Melt Gunner. I guess they're really best friends now. Yeah, usually these flashback episodes, everyone's at level 90. It's really weird, but not him. I guess it's because of the training he went through in Ouroboros.
That newbie acting like he owns the place!
Oh? Since when has the society's hierarchy been based on seniority? But no need to look so glum. I'll be certain to find a suitable use for you as an enforcer.
I will not stand for this!
Commander?
The battle is over, sir. I think we should accept...
I'm not accepting anything! I will not be walked all over by this twerp! To my side, Geopash!
So this is your personal aircraft I've heard so much about,
Isn't that intimidating? Good. It's going to teach you some respect, newbie! Watch and learn how a real Ouroboros veteran fights!
Alright, this has gone on long enough.
Let him have his fun, Gareth.
Are you sure?
Our boy wants to be an enforcer, yeah? Then let him fight his own battles. This is a good chance to see what he can do.
Very well. I'll attend your little class. And once I graduate, I'll show you that I'm done being used. From now on, I'll live life by my terms.
Victory is in the bag!
Yep. What? Very well.
Burning cry.
Flames that kindle within me.
Ignite!
You might want to run so you don't get caught up in any silly AoEs. Go in this corner, that's a nice corner.
Very well.
Can you even be set on fire? 5% chance, that's never happening. What? Okay. Earth Pulse Self. Tira? Oh, nuts. That's a lot of healing.
Here I go.
Well, I got zero turn, so, I'm very weak to fire, so zero cannon should do a lot of damage.
Here I go!
I don't have any... Wait, I do have one person who can impede, the robot.
Got you!
Talisman!
Whoa, it actually stopped him. Damn, he can cast really quick.
You're finished!
Here I go!
Flames that...
This guy's so tanky now, huh? Yes!
Here I go!
Hmm.
Grant me strength! Carmine Heart! Here I go!
Very well.
Purgatory Saber.
Flames, flicker, and roar! Now, gather in my blade! Purgatory Saber!
What the? This hundred jump was just repaired! Woohoo!
Do you have a Grail locket or something? I'm not sure. All Curia is pretty convenient. Nice.
You're finished!
It does magic damage to chaff grenade.
Very well.
Hey.
Here I go!
Flame. Very well.
Critical mode.
Very well.
Damn, he's gonna steal that bonus no matter what. I should have saved up enough for Chrono Burst. Gee, Max.
Cute.
Oh no, it's hitting both of them.
That! Woohoo! Get a good look! It's about to get real! Not so cute now! What?
I can't believe you survived that, little robot.
Here I go!
Flames that...
Here I go!
Woohoo!
What?
That was close.
Very well.
You're finished!
That's a lot. He's still going that strong, huh? Earth Pulse.
Hut!
Here I go!
They're all cannon.
Hut! Here I go!
Flick!
Armor break.
Very well.
Got you! Talisman Blade!
Almost there. But he instantly broke out. Impede, please.
Very well.
Got you! Talisman Blade! All right! Flames flicker and roar! Now, gather in my blade! Purgatory Saber!
No! Tell me this is a bad dream!
This is just the beginning!
Well, I just realized this means Gilbert is stronger than Class 7 right now.
I shall waver no more!
And the robot is happy, probably. I don't know.
Say the line!
Gilbert.
Blarf!
Yay!
Commander.
Not again.
Not bad. See, you can do it if you put your mind to it.
I hope you aren't implying that this was in any way a challenge. My goal is to be an enforcer. Small fry like him won't stand in my way.
Now that's more like it. You should keep fighting like your life depends on it. That's the most fun way to live, if you ask me.
I can't say that sounds very tempting, knowing your twisted sense of fun. But very well, I welcome any challenge. The path I've chosen is in no way righteous, but it is the right path for me. I must learn to walk it and continue forward, even when I'm separated from those who care for me. I've no right to thank any of you, let alone face you and ask for your forgiveness. However, Kurt, Alfin, Olivert, and Reen, I still...
Day of the wedding. While everyone was slacking off, Cedric was trying to maintain his levels.
I wish you well, Olivert.
Though he's technically still lower leveled than the endgame levels of Cold Steel 4 for some reason. And there's the Ouroboros Orbment. The Orbment cover. Would it be playable in the corridor, though? Prominence Nova. Alright, Project Orbital Gear 4. Am I gonna have to fight the Orbital Gear with Agate again? That was really hard. Looks like most of the problems have been addressed. The combat data from the last test proved useful then. Very, I owe the team a lot. The Robo Gear 3 is officially complete. And you get a passing grade, I suppose. So what next? Oh, I haven't given that much thought, actually. Which means your schedule is open. Try analyzing this. What is it? No questions. Huh, but then how? Oh, you want me to figure that part out? There's no rush on your findings, nor is there a need to provide periodic updates. You're free to proceed however you wish. Is there something else? No. It's just you seem to be so swamped with work lately that I was wondering if I could help lighten the load.
That's what I'm here for! Who... what?
There you are, Professor Russell.
Long time no see, Professor Schmidt, and thank you for keeping a watchful eye over my Tita.
Mom, why are you here? Why are all of you here?
Sorry to drop in, Tita. We were just escorting your mom.
And I'm here on a job. A very troublesome job, as it so happens.
How so?
That can wait. There's something much more important here than work. And that's you, my baby's breath bundle of cuteness! Oh, how your mommy has missed you!
Mom?
And you've only gotten cuter! Oh, I can't believe it. It's a scientific marvel. They gotta have laws against going over cute capacity because I just can't take it.
Stop it, Mom! Everyone is watching!
Let them. I get to hug and kiss and love on my favorite little girl. My Tita tank's been running on empty for months!
Professor?
Just let her get it out of her system.
Poor Tita.
Please! This is so embarrassing!
If you're going to fritter away my time, do it where I can't see it.
I'm sorry.
My apologies. I sometimes forget that my enthusiasm could give a man with already one foot in his grave a heart attack.
There you are with that cheek. I would assume you were the child if I didn't know that was your daughter standing next to you.
Why, thank you. My imagination is as rich as a child's. A good thing, too, since my partner now is a senile old fart whose last good idea may have predated our concept of time.
The nerve.
I can't tell if they hate each other or if this is just their thing.
I'm leaning toward the latter.
She's the only engineer I know who can have at it with the professor.
Probably because she's gonna be him in 30 years. Unlike her old man who just loves throwing whatever shit he can find together, these two develop tech with specific goals in mind. They also don't mind throwing everyone else under the bus if it means meeting those goals.
Hey, Red! I got ears.
So, the job?
Right. Time to get down to business.
So you're forming a team to handle problems the Black Workshop left behind?
In short, yes.
The workshops left scars all across the land.
Their weapons, autonomous and otherwise, are on the black market. It could be people are scavenging for remnants of them.
However they're going about it, it's going to be a problem in time. The guild's on full alert.
That sounds rough. No wonder you're here.
I came here as a representative of ZCF after receiving a formal request from the Imperial government.
Professor Schmidt and Russell are acting as the linchpins of the team. I'm here since I was connected to the workshop. And the guild is working with us as a safety measure. All of this is being coordinated via the Reinford Company. We'll be investigating old sites while figuring out what to do with the weapons we find in said sites.
I see. I'm surprised you agreed to help, Professor.
I don't see it as helping. I couldn't care less what the government or the guild wants. All I want is the data the Black Workshop left behind.
Yeah, I can't wait to get my hands on it all.
You two have a one-track mind.
Do you think I could be a part of the team? I'd love to be of some help.
Well...
You don't have to do a thing, Tita.
But...
I did say this job is troublesome, but as you can see, we have more than enough people to go around. And I didn't come all this way for nothing.
We don't even have to worry about funding, since RF and the government's footing the bill.
Father was such a large part of this that my mother and I are by default. If it takes all of Reinford's resources to put an end to it, then that's just what we'll have to do.
And if anybody tries to get rough, they got the bracers to let them know what's what.
I mean,
I was never going to worry about that. I know you guys are there.
Then you know we're all set. The best thing you can do right now is focus on school.
But what about you? You're in school too.
I sure am. Dean Collins allowed this as part of extracurricular activities. I might even present a new thesis based on my findings.
So why can't I do what you're doing?
There's nothing you can do for this team. Why not make sure Makarov's damn niece doesn't set fire to the building while I'm out?
Oh, Professor. I know mint can be a lot, but even she wouldn't.
Whoa! That wrench went flying! Huh? How'd it get caught in the vent? Whoa! It caught on fire! This place is about to go up in smoke!
I'm on my way.
Project Orbital Gear 4, Part 1. So we'll be hanging out in the Empire for a little while. How long exactly? This particular problem's pretty broad, so we're thinking it'll take about 4 months or so. That long? Dan, that mechanic, and that maniac should be able to hold down the fort just fine. I've got some things I need taken care of as soon as I'm back, but who could resist all this workshop business? Are you sure there isn't anything I can do to help? It's fine, don't worry, my little angel. The schedule itself isn't very packed, to be honest. Most of our time will be spent on data analysis. Yep, if anything decides to get in our way, we'll give him a real smackdown and sell things in a jiffy. So don't stress, okay? If you say so. If push comes to shove, I can always sacrifice this guy here. I don't mind. Heh heh. Mom. Just kidding. Bullshit. Oh, I get you silly stupid man. Why would I have to resort to sacrificing you when there are so many other fun ways to use a pack mule over the next 4 months? Fun, huh? You can lay off the murderous intent anytime now. Oh, it'll be fun, alright. Fun for me. Ah ha ha ha. I get stuck looking over his shoulder for the rest of his days. It's like her obsession with Agatha has gone into overdrive after he and Tita went to the Empire. You do live a life of suffering, don't you? A normal person would have killed over by now. Must be the A-ranker in you. Do you not sound so impressed? Heh. What's got you so giggly? Just seeing us all together like this brings me back home is all. Well, home will always be there for when you're ready for it. And since things are more or less back to normal, how do you like your school, Tita? The press couldn't stop talking about force during the war, especially instructors. And well, everyone's really nice. There's lots of funny, interesting people around here. I was a little afraid when I first came here, but now I feel totally fine. That's good, huh? Sounds like you made some wonderful memories. Yeah. So make sure you give them a proper goodbye so you don't sour those fond memories. Huh? Don't worry, once you're solid, you can invite all your friends to come see you in Liberal. Come think of it, I need to carve out some time in my schedule to talk this out with your instructors. Wait a second, Mom, what are you talking about? Why do I need to say goodbye? Are you graduating soon? What? I'm not just here on a job, Tita. I'm here to take you back home. What? Why? This is so out of nowhere. Not as much as you think. I heard that the branch campus stood in opposition to the government during the war. You think I'd leave my daughter in such a dangerous place after hearing that? But what if our overall test score average goes down because of this? I don't want to lose the main campus. There was a good reason behind that. We were just trying to... The reason isn't the point. You were caught and put under house arrest for a while, weren't you? Sure, but it all worked out. You got to use your orbital gear a few times, I think. If it hadn't, all it would have taken was a single small mistake, and I might have never seen my little girl again. I still can't bear a fight even now. Mom, I know you might hate me for taking you back, but I can handle that. I can't handle losing you. But I want to stay here a little longer, at least until graduation. Come on, Erica, she's been working her ass off over here. Zip it, Agate. If you'd protected her like you were supposed to, she wouldn't have been in danger in the first place. Who was it who was so cocky when he said he'd keep her safe the day he left, huh? Because it certainly wasn't... It's certainly not you. Don't blame Agate for this. No one could have predicted what happened. I just don't have the experience to... Didn't have... Nah, she's right. If I'd done my job, you wouldn't have been half the trouble you were in. I got nothing to defend myself with. Still. Enough... With that said, let me ask you this. Why do you want to stay after all that's happened? Well, I'm still in the middle of classes. It'll be another year until I graduate. That doesn't matter. You don't care? Not as much as I care about the real reason you came to Erebonia. I want to study under Professor Schmidt and complete the orbital gear free. And since Estelle and Joshua couldn't come here before, I figured I could be the one to help Olivier out. Now those answers matter. I read your report. I think you did amazing work on the orbital gear free, which of course my daughter would. Prince Oliver is safe, and your friends can now enter the country with no problem. From where I'm sitting, you've already gotten everything you could out of Erebonia. When you put it like that, maybe, but... Did all of you know Mom came here to take me home? Yes, we did. We tried convincing her otherwise. You sure won't reconsider? I think you know I'll say that, Estelle. But Tita really likes it here. What's the harm in letting her enjoy it while she's still in school? She likes being at home too, and there's nothing she couldn't learn in Liberal that she'd learn in Erebonia. That means it's time for her to come back home. That's not true. Am I really wrong? I think so. But I can keep producing results, and that proves there's more I could stand to learn here, right? Or I suppose. The logic certainly sound enough. We'll be here for a while, so I see no reason not to entertain the idea. We'll have all plenty of time to wait for her to produce results. She still has to to analyze that weird box. We'll be operating out of the branch campus since it's where Professor Schmidt is staying. I highly doubt Tita will be in any danger between now and when we leave. No way she would. Sigh, fine. Really? Yes, really, but on two conditions. First, you must produce results that can convince me within 4 months. Second, after that, you must clear a test of my choosing. If you can fulfill those two conditions, I'll let you stay at Forest until graduation. Fair? Fair. Maybe Erica's gonna bring in her own orbital gear and you're gonna have to duke it out in orbital gears? Orbital Gear 4. This almost looks like it's gonna turn into a menu where I have to play a mini game. Alright, it's life or death here, so let's kick off our first official meetup for Project Orbital Gear 4. Oh man, it's not that big a deal, we're just brainstorming. You say that, but if your mom isn't happy with what we come up with, then she's gonna pull you from the branch campus. I know. So it is life or death. There's no such thing as going overboard today, because we're as on board can be. We'll need every resource the engineering team has here can get their hands on, so let's rock this out. Hi, Lassie. We don't plan skipping if you're at stake. That's so sweet. Okay, so I do have to help my uncle with his project, so I won't be able to help all the time. Sorry. Can't say we're going to be much help either. We may have some trouble following along when it comes to the more complex aspects of this project. That's perfectly okay, just having you here means the world to me. I've got to be the one to handle most of it. If I hand too much over, then it's like I've lost the point of it being given to me. You're so nice. But what about the box that Schmidt gave you? That's the spirit, forget everything else. We're here for you 100%. Don't tell me that box is good. You're going to jam it right into the orbital gear 4 and it's going to become just as strong as a soul dot. Let's do this. Thank you, guys. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's really kick off our first official meetup for Project Orbital Gear 4. Keep saying first, miss. So how many more meetings do you have planned with this project? Zero. We've only got 4 months, so if we don't figure out what we need to do right now, we're gonna be screwed on time. Then why call it first? It felt cool, you know? I was just going with it. So, Tia, number 4, eh? You just finished developing your orbital gear free, right? It can't be easy trying to one-up yourself so soon. If you're going to convince the professor to let you say, shouldn't you go with less of a challenge? No, it has to be this. My mom designed the first orbital gear. If I really want to recognize my skills, then proving the very thing she started is the way to go. I got you now. Makes sense. And you won't hear another word from us. So where do we start? Do you have a concept in mind for Little Baby 4 that's bigger, better than Big Daddy 3? Little Baby 4, Big Daddy 3? It's a wee world, that little noggin, Gustav. Trying to understand it will just do your own head in. Oh, that's what I'm stuck on right now. Everyone's help turn the orbital gear free into something with incredible specs. Surpassing that is going to require some major overhaul. I don't even know where to start. That'll put a damper on things, yeah. Well, what can't the previous models do? What can we add? It's gotta be something. You know, I felt my heart skip a beat when I first saw a Panzer slot flying around. What about that? Flying? Yeah, that could. You have an idea? Any more faces than I think I was going through pics on a stereoscope. I can't even tell if you like the idea or not. I like the direction, but we wouldn't be the first to do it. The orbital gear is a Russell thing, isn't it? It is, but 2 years ago, ZCF and the Epstein Foundation joint developed something called the Edelon gear. It's like a sister weapon to the orbital gear. Oh, like Elisa's EXA? Yeah, but three companies were involved with the EXA, whereas the Edelon gear mostly has Foundation tech to make it stand out. I'm almost certain it was capable of manned flight. Wow, ain't that something? Is there a reason the Free didn't incorporate it if the technology is already out there? Well, to be honest, it's because I just don't know a whole lot about the Edelon gear. That's an easy fix, all you gotta do is ask. Ask Tio? I understand, I'll answer any questions you have. Thank you so much, Tio. You need to thank me, ZCF helped make it happen, so it's the least I can do to share. To start, Edelon gear did achieve flight to some degree, but it was far from perfect. What happened? Two things, performance and operational time. It's possible to fly with a pilot in the seat, but add another curum and performance drops dramatically. It also significantly reduces how long it can operate. It reduces how long it can operate. It isn't designed for multi-purpose work for long periods. Forget flight combat. Let's see, Orbital Gear 3 solved the operational time issue and adapted well to suit its pilot's needs on the spot. Another thing is that the Edelon gear can't function without first linking with the Eon system. It was a progressive machine for its time, but also came with some very big limitations. So it had some incredible stuff to it, but it lacked the versatility of the Free. And I don't think we even use Edelon gear anymore, do we? And adding a flight function to the Free wouldn't be such a bad idea at all. Not bad, it's pure brilliant is what. Sounds like it would work much better than anything that's come before it, yeah. It's not like we can just slap it on, right? It only got so much heft, and it's not like we can apply some kind of booster like with the Panzer Solots. It will not be very easy veering around tight turns with how it's built too. It's not easy isn't the same as impossible, so no matter how hard it is, I'm gonna make it happen. Oh, you're all kinds of inspired. We have some materials that could help. So I'll put them together and send them to you in a bit. Thank you. Thanks for your input, we now have a plan, and this one is sure to make Mom see what I'm made of. But it's only part one. 1 month later. How's progress going? We brought some snacks. Oh, hi Sandy, hi Freddy. You look like you've seen better days. That's nothing Freddy's fighting formula can't fix. Go on, give it a bite. What's in it? It's a special blend of 7 kinds of bugs that help fight fatigue. It's bitter, it's so bitter. But what is this deep, rich aftertaste? It's like I'm being swapped in a warm blanket of pure energy. Ooh, I feel like a whole new Tia now. Nothing beats a second win, right? More like nothing beats whatever it is you just gave me. I've got some sandwiches too, if you're hungry. I love some, Sandy, and thanks so much, Ray. No thanks needed. Anything for a cooking club comrade. Right, I haven't been able to drop by the club at all lately. Please, if anything, we wish we could do more for you. We're in your corner, Tia. Next year won't be the same if you weren't there to cook with us. I really want to stay too. So far, so good on the plan then, I hope. Well, going by how out of it you were, I'm guessing not. I made prototype after prototype, but none of them quite make the cut in terms of specs. I feel bad since everyone's going out of their way to help, but to be honest, I'm stumped. Have you tried asking Professor Schmidt? I don't know, he might just glare at her before brushing her off. I know he's a little scary up front, but I think he'd still give me a hint if I asked. It's just that I don't want him to. My friend's helping me out is one thing, but he's a professor. If this whole thing moves forward based on the input of someone whose mom's equal, then is it really my project anymore? That's a valid point, sure. But that means your roadblock's not going anywhere. So when I hit a wall on something, I do something else to take my mind off of it. Oh, you know, I do that too. If I'm stuck on cooking, I like to go out hunting. Wanna take a run through the mountains? Yeah, I'll pass on the mountains, but I like the direction this is going. Actually, I haven't analyzed that the device that Professor Smith gave me yet. I think I'll start there. Who knows? Maybe I can even solve it if I pull another all-nighter. I'm not sure that's gonna help. What? Sure it is. Different strokes, Sandy. Do what makes you tick, Tita. As long as you don't overdo it, anyway. Thanks, you two. What's up with this reaction? Is this some sort of gravitational engine? But how is it so small? I can't think of any practical use for this off the top of my head. Could be a prototype. I think I get why the professor gave this to me now. Yeah, and now here. Oh, Professor Schmidt, do you have a moment? Only just, keep it brief. It's about the device you gave me. If I told you there wasn't a need for periodic updates. It's not that, I just wanted to confirm something about how it's used. Do whatever you want with it. Huh? It said do whatever you want with it. Now, no more questions. Specifically saying jam it right into your orbital gear to solve your flying issues. And I will. Thank you, Professor. I'll see you later. Hmm? Two months later. North Languedoc Canyon Road. Okay, time for the final operational trial. Fighting Agate with it? I guess it'll have to be. You've only got 2 days until you present your fighting Serica. You ought to be proud of how far you've come. Maybe. I never dreamed the unit the professor gave me would turn out to be a new gravitational engine. The internals were really unique, so it took lots of tweaking to make it work. But after fitting it to this prototype, I can't believe the kind of results I was getting. Is this still stable? What if it goes out of control? So that's the direction I needed to follow. After that, new ideas kept coming, and the prototype was done before I knew it. I've done a few flight tests and made improvements after each, and now... Oh, what is it, Agate? Nothing, I just like how passionate you are. Oh, hey, sometimes I just get the fire in me and I can't stop yammering. Anyway, thanks for coming with me today. Like, I'd let you come all the way out here alone. Why'd you pick a spot in the middle of nowhere like this anyway? Well, this is my last chance to collect data, so I wanted to make the most of it. Nobody comes here, and the elevation is naturally uneven. It's just perfect for flying around. Makes sense. Well, go wild. I'll be here watching you the whole way, so let me know if you need anything. Okay, I'm gonna get started. Maybe I have to do a racing course where I have to try to not run to obstacles and try to make it to the end. I don't know. Maybe I have to go through flying rings. How much power is left after that flight? Okay, I finished the test course now. Good stuff, here's all the numbers you wanted. I have no idea if they're good or not. Looks like you were flying pretty well to me though. Oh, this is a big success, huge. Mom's bound to be satisfied by numbers like this. Awesome, guess all that's left is for Mama Bear to go over with a fine-tooth comb. Sounds like you've got it in the bag. Thanks so much for all the help, Agate. Maybe it's a bit premature to be saying this before Mom gives the okay. I'm gonna need more of that while I'm at the academy. Heh, yeah, I got you. Gil's still understaffed in the Empire, so I wasn't planning on hanging home anytime soon. Coming to check on you every so often is easy enough. Heh, yay. What the? Something's up with that airship. Could be some kind of mechanical failure. If the pilot can't ascend, it's going to crash into the mountain. It's just not good. Good timing. A good thing I have this unit. I'm going to go and help. Tita! Do you have enough energy, though? Its flight feels completely down. Can someone there hear me? Who are you? There's no time to explain. Just please, tell inside something. I'll do what I can. What can an orbital gear do to stop an airship? That seems a bit beyond its specs. They need to elevate it somehow. Full power. I don't think you have enough power for something like that, do you? Oh, this isn't enough. Releasing output limiter. Oh no. Why does the airship have to show up now of all time?
Please, just a bit more.
You're releasing a limiter. You're probably not. There's no way you can present this to your mom. You'll have to rebuild it from the... take a while to repair it. Hurry up and land.
I did it.
No. I feel like something bad's gonna happen.
Now I just need to get back to Agate. Huh? Don't tell me it overheated. Huh?
I hope we brought a parachute.
Agate!
You okay, Tina?
By the skin of my teeth, but yeah. I'm okay.
I can't take my eyes off of you for a second now, can I? Nothing but trouble, I swear.
I'm so sorry. If I hadn't run off like that on my own...
I'm teasing. You got nothing to apologize for. You probably saved the lives of everyone on that airship. You did the right thing, Tita.
You mean it?
Still, you might be safe.
But we can't say the same for the Orbal Gear 4, huh?
What? So you're behind this too? Man, this guy just can't let us have anything good, can he? The two eventually descended to the bottom of the canyon and recovered the Orbal Gear 4's wreckage. Unfortunately, it was clear that a few days wouldn't be enough to fix it, and particularly, the new engine within was nowhere to be found. Wait, what? Was that new engine related to the Monarch's regalia somehow? He stole it. Why would he need to if he already has gravity powers? In the end, Tina returned to Branch Campus in low spirits. Agate gently patting her on the back in an effort to cheer her up, and they couldn't mass produce that gravitational engine. That's depressing. Thanks for tuning in to this Let's Play of Trails in the Reverie. If you enjoyed, please leave a like, subscribe, and or hit the bell icon.